a session specifically on Leave It, okay? So if there are shoes on the floor, if there's a napkin on the floor, if there's a toy on the floor, and I need her to leave it or not pick it up, whether that's food or whatever the case is, then I'm gonna tell her just that, which is to leave it. And I'll probably put some vibration on her or a tone on her depending on what I'm asking her to do. But I just wanted to explain it a little bit more with her toy, okay? So we're gonna call for the out. And I'm gonna tell her to leave it. Now, I'll put it, leave it. I'll put it right next to my side. Anytime she tries to mouth for it, I'm gonna pull it and tell her to leave it. But I'm gonna put it right back in her face, in her space, because I need her to walk with me. Come on. Here again, if she mouths for it, I'm gonna pull it and say, leave it. Sit. Didn't push, but I just put a little light pressure on her butt. I'll tell her to heel. Heel. And sit. Heel. Place. Sit. Alright. So, as you can see, we should be able to put objects right into her face or right next to her on the floor or whatever the case is and tell her to leave it, and she should be understanding to that. Now, this is a piece of port, highly desirable. I'm going to tell her to stay and leave it. Leave it. Leave it. A little physical pressure just on her nose right there to make sure to sit, that she didn't touch it. Make sure that she's nice and patient. The only thing that is gonna release her is her release word that we've told her, which is gonna be sit. Okay. Good. You can see she understands that okay really well. Okay means that no pressure is coming on her. If she goes towards the item that we are either telling her to stay away from or to leave. So it's important that we continue to use the release of okay, so that she understands when she can or when she cannot do something. And it's important that we use the toy and also food objects to teach her to leave stuff. Now, I will teach her to leave stuff and then she can get it, but then I'll also tell her to leave stuff completely. Now you sit. I'm gonna say stay and leave it. Leave it. Now I'm gonna put that on one side of her and I'm on the other side of her and I'm gonna say, Maggie, come. Maggie, come. I'm gonna tell her to leave it. Now she'll go after it in a second and I'm gonna tell her sternly with my voice and assertively to leave it if she goes for that, okay? Maggie, come. And sit. And now that she's given me patience and understanding, then I'll tell her she can have it, and how I tell her is with her release. Okay. Okay. Took two okays and me pointing to it, but then she understood. Everything is good on this now. We can now go with it. So, sometimes when I tell her to leave it, I will call her off of stuff and she does not get it ever. Sometimes when I'm using leave it, it'll be a single object and then she can get it immediately afterwards. Sometimes I tell her to leave it, I'm going to call her to come and I'm going to work around the object and then she might get it or she might not get it afterwards. But hopefully this helps you guys out with the leave it behavior. She understands it and she understands that there's either body pressure or e-collar pressure or prong collar pressure that comes on her if she does not comply with what I'm asking. And with her toy, if she tries to get it before, I'll pull it away and I'll tell her to leave it and she loses the reward being right there next to her, because she was trying to be impulsive. Okay, come on. Okay. Let's see, we'll switch right back to the ball. But let me know if you have any questions. All right, guys.